10 mind-blowing facts about the solar system. Number 10. Where's the biggest crater in the solar system? The biggest crater in the solar system is on the moon and is called the Aitken crater. This crater has a diameter of an impressive 2,500 kilometers. That's about half the size of Australia. The Aitken crater is located in the southern part of the moon and spans the entire South Pole-Aitken basin. This crater is a giant, and its size is difficult to comprehend. To put it in perspective, the giant crater on Earth, Vredefort Crater in South Africa, is only 300 kilometers in diameter. Even the famous Barringer crater in Arizona, one of the largest on Earth, is only 1.2 kilometers in diameter. The Aitken crater was formed about 4 billion years ago when a giant asteroid collided with the moon. The impact was so powerful that it created a vast basin that can be seen even from Earth with powerful telescopes. The Aitken crater is bottomless and has some of the oldest and most primitive terrains in the solar system. Although the Aitken crater is the largest in the solar system, an even more enormous crater may be discovered at some point in the future. Space exploration continues, and we are learning more and more about our solar system. But for now, the Aitken crater remains the king of craters. Number 9. Mercury's core is huge. Mercury is the smallest of the planets in the solar system, but it has a disproportionately large core compared to its size. Mercury's core is about 85% of the planet's diameter and mainly consists of iron. Mercury's core is so large compared to the planet's size due to its early formation. Scientists believe that Mercury formed about 4.5 billion years ago from the remnants of the nebula that formed the solar system. In the early days of the solar system, the nebula was filled with dust and gas, and collisions between dust and gas grains allowed the accumulation of materials in larger bodies. Mercury suffered a catastrophic collision with a Mars-sized object during the formation process, removing much of the planet's crust. However, Mercury's iron core, which had already begun to form, remained intact and grew. Over time, the core became the main component of the planet. In addition to the planet's early formation, Mercury's close location to the Sun may also have contributed to the size of its core. The intense radiation from the Sun and the high temperature on the planet's surface could have caused the iron in the core to melt, causing it to grow even more significantly. Number 8. Uranus's rings are almost invisible. Uranus is the seventh planet in the solar system and is characterized as a gas giant with a very dark asteroid ring in its orbit. This ring, known as the Uranus ring, is so dark that it can barely be made out from its surroundings. Scientists believe the ring's dark color is due to dust and ice particles struck by micrometeorites over billions of years. This activity has darkened the surface of the ring, causing it to absorb visible light and reflect very little. In addition, Uranus's ring is made mainly of carbon particles and water ice, which also contributes to its darkness. These particles are believed to be remnants of comets and asteroids that broke up after being deflected by the planet's gravity. Although scientists have studied Uranus's ring for decades, they still don't fully understand why it is so dark. More research and space missions are needed to solve this mystery. Number 7. Spot of Saturn. Jupiter's Great Red Spot is well known to everyone, but did you know that Saturn also has a substantial spot? This white spot was first discovered by the Voyager spacecraft in 1980 and has been observed by various space missions since then. It is believed to be a big storm similar to Jupiter's Great Red Spot, although much shorter in duration. The white spot is caused by the convection of gases in Saturn's upper atmosphere, creating a giant storm with white clouds. The storm moves around the planet with atmospheric winds lasting from a few months to several years. In 2010, the Cassini spacecraft observed Saturn's white spot, which had formed a few years earlier. Scientists could measure the speed of the winds circling the storm and found they were the strongest ever measured on Saturn, with speeds of up to 550 kilometers per hour. The white spot is just one of many exciting features on Saturn, which continues to be the subject of study and research by scientists and astronomers worldwide. Future space missions will reveal more secrets about this fascinating planet and its environment. Number 6. Neptune Spot. If we talk about spots, Jupiter and Saturn are not the only ones that have, since Neptune also has its storm that appears from time to time. The dark spot on Neptune was first discovered in 1989 by the Voyager 2 spacecraft. The dark spot is a vast dark vortex in the planet's atmosphere, believed to be a massive storm similar to Jupiter's Great Red Spot. Unlike the Great Red Spot, which has been around for at least 300 years, Neptune's dark spot has a much shorter life cycle. The spot first appeared in 1989, disappeared in 1990, and reappeared in 1994 before fading again in 1995. Since then, it has appeared and disappeared several times. The reason Neptune's dark spot appears and disappears remains a mystery. It is believed that strong winds blowing in the planet's atmosphere may be creating vortices that drag dark materials towards the surface. Other scientists have suggested that the spot could be related to changes in solar activity, which affect the chemical composition of Neptune's atmosphere. Although it is not yet fully understood why Neptune's dark spot appears and disappears, its study has helped scientists better understand the complex dynamics of the giant planets in the solar system. Number 5. Do Uranus and Neptune rain diamonds? The answer is yes, although probably not in the way you imagine. Uranus and Neptune are known as the ice giants of the solar system, as they are made mostly of ice, rock, and gases like hydrogen, helium, and methane. However, as we go deeper into the atmosphere of these planets, the pressure and temperature increase dramatically. Due to these extreme conditions, the methane decomposes and the carbon molecules are compressed and crystallized, forming small diamond particles. These particles are carried by the violent winds of the planets and are deposited in the deepest layers of the atmosphere. But does it rain diamonds on Uranus and Neptune? Not quite. Due to the extreme pressure and temperature deep in the atmosphere of these planets, diamonds can't fall to the surface. Also, these planets' rain mainly comprises of methane and other gases. However, the formation of diamonds in the atmosphere of Uranus and Neptune remains a fascinating and unique phenomena in the solar system. Number 4. Why is the solar corona so hot? The solar corona is the outermost and most visible layer of the Sun's atmosphere. It is a region of ionized gas that extends millions of kilometers in space and can be seen during a total solar eclipse. A corona is a place of high activity full of magnetic fields, plasma flows, and solar explosions. The corona is surprisingly hot despite being very far from the Sun's surface. It is much hotter than the Sun's surface, the photosphere. While the temperature of the photosphere is around 5,500 degrees Celsius, the corona temperature is several million degrees Celsius. The reason for this high temperature remains a mystery to scientists. One theory is that the magnetic energy stored in the corona is released as heat through non-linear heating processes. Others believe that the energy may come from plasma waves or the energy released during solar flares. Despite its high temperature, the solar corona does not feel hot when viewed from Earth. The corona is highly dim and energy dissipates into space. However, solar activity in the corona can significantly affect Earth, such as interference with satellite communications and power grids. Number 3. Oort cloud. The Oort cloud is a hypothetical region of the solar system located between 2,000 and 100,000 astronomical units from the Sun, up to a quarter of the distance between our solar system and the nearest star. This cloud is the theoretical home of trillions of icy bodies such as comets and dwarf planets. The Oort cloud is believed to have formed from remnants of the nebula, the cloud of gas and dust that gave rise to the solar system some 4.6 billion years ago. The bodies in this cloud are considered fossils of the solar system's formation process. Despite its enormous size, the Oort cloud is complicated to detect directly because its component objects are so small and distant. However, comets that appear to come from this region have been observed, suggesting that the cloud exists and is the source of many of the long-period comets observed in the solar system. Much of this cloud is still unknown, and it is hoped that future research in space missions can help unravel the Oort cloud mysteries and the solar system's formation. Number 2. Least visited planet of all. Despite being discovered in 1781, few space missions have reached the planet Uranus due to its distance and location in the outer solar system. The first and only mission to visit Uranus was the Voyager 2 probe, which flew by the planet in 1986. During that mission, the probe took pictures and collected information about the planet's atmosphere, rings, and moons. Since then, no missions have been dedicated to exploring Uranus in detail. Despite the lack of exploration, astronomers have learned much about Uranus from telescopes on the ground and in space. Uranus is known to be a gas giant planet, similar in size and composition to Neptune. It has an atmosphere made mostly of hydrogen and helium, but also contains small amounts of methane. The presence of methane is believed to give Uranus its distinctive blue-green color. Despite not being fully explored, Uranus remains a fascinating object in the solar system, and there are many unanswered questions about its atmosphere, climate, and rings and moons. Hopefully in the future, there will be more missions to explore this enigmatic planet and discover all it has to offer. Number 1. The only natural satellite with a magnetic field. Ganymede is one of Jupiter's most fascinating satellites, since it is the only one with a magnetic field. This magnetic field is believed to be generated by the interaction of Jupiter's magnetic field with the interior of Ganymede. This interaction can be explained by an underground saltwater ocean below the satellite's surface. The subterranean ocean of Ganymede is in constant motion and is responsible for generating electrical currents. These electrical currents, in turn, generate a magnetic field that extends around the satellite. This magnetic field is believed to be due to dissolved salts in the water, which conduct electricity and produce a magnetic field. Ganymede is the only satellite in our solar system known to have a significant magnetic field, but it is not the only body in the solar system to have a magnetic field. Most planets and many other bodies, such as the Moon and some asteroids, have magnetic fields to a greater or lesser degree. However, Ganymede's magnetic field is unique due to its origin, resulting from the interaction between the underground ocean and Jupiter's magnetic field. And that was the last mind-blowing fact about the solar system, episode 6. If you missed the other episodes, why don't you check them out? I promise you'll love them. Thanks for watching.